Hi, I am Sina Nera Sina. Welcome back to Disgaea 1 Complete. Okay, we're in episode, let's see, 12. Yeah, I think it's episode 12 now. Angels, Demons, and Humans. Ah, it's episode 10 in-game, by the way. So, let's start. Poor Gordon.
What humiliation. The defender of Earth working for the Overlord. I can't apologize enough to my predecessors.
You look unhappy.
I'm actually interested in, like, Gordon's predecessors, the other defenders of Earth.
Don't tell me that a hero would break his promise now.
But it's too bad that Gordon's life is not explored further from this game. In the other games, he doesn't appear much. Maybe, I think, in 2 he makes a cameo, and on subsequent games he appears as DLC and things like that.
A hero never breaks a promise.
And also humans, like, in general, they don't appear that much in future Disgaea games. I think in Disgaea 3 there was Almas, who was a human warrior. But aside from that, no, it's always just demons and angels.
All I can do right now is endure this. As long as my faith does not falter, hope remains.
But I'll talk a little more about that later.
I've got it. I'll just pretend to obey him. And when he lets his guard down, I'll escape back to Earth. All right, I just need to have patience. Good thinking, Gordon.
Your eyes are full of hope. You're planning something, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I was just...
Morning, Harley.
I told you not to call me that!
Why not? It's cuter that way. Etna and Flan are going to show me around the Netherworld, and we're going to have a picnic. Why don't you come along, Harley? We made a great lunch.
Picnic? You must be joking, Jennifer. I, the defender of Earth, am working, and you, my assistant, are picnicking?
But Gordon, today's Sunday. It's a day off for everybody.
Well, that's true, but... Thursday, you'll stay here and work with me, right?
Robots require rest, too. Thursday, we'll attend picnic with Jennifer. La, la, la.
Hey, you traitor!
There you have it, Gordon. We'll leave the chores to you.
So, where should we go?
It's your first time in the Netherworld. So how about the Sea of Gehenna?
Why? It's so hot over there.
What kind of a place is it?
It's a big tourist spot. Since you're new to the Netherworld,
I'm not pressing A, by the way.
Check it out.
Is there a souvenir shop around?
It's not exactly the kind of place that sells souvenirs.
Well, if it's souvenirs you're looking for, try Sphinxes on Sacrifice Street. They've got nice mummy hats. See? Oh, how adorable!
Hey, that's the Nether Year 666 Limited Edition model! I want one!
Too bad!
Okay, today it's a picnic at the Sea of Gehenna, and tomorrow it's shopping on
Sacrifice Street. She probably sent the prinnies to get that. I can imagine Etna just... Yeah, I can imagine Etna, like, making a line or anything.
Alright, we're going to the Sea of Gehenna. I will never, ever allow those women to go picnicking on their own.
That's a great idea. We should do it. It's not like we'd be going on a picnic going la la la. Someone has to protect them.
Right, let's go.
All right, you two lazy bones. I know you want to go to a picnic.
Here's my chance. I'll sneak off and escape during the picnic.
Episode 10, Angels, Demons, and Humans.
Okay, so I literally just started the episode right away, so, you know, I haven't developed anything. Oh, it's too bad that Gordon, Jennifer, and Thursday are level 32. I thought they were going to be level, you know, 39. I have to equip them. Okay, let's start with Gordon. I think I bought a good gun last time. I guess I can use this one. It's a little better than the Ion 9K Samurai. No, wait. It's a little worse. Well, at least I have something better than a bulletproof vest. That much I can tell you. Yeah, the stealth cape. Ah, let's just buy things in the shop. Huh. So these are the defenders of Earth. Oh my god, Gordon, the bones are talking. Calm down, Jennifer. This is the Netherworld. Bones can talk too. Humans must be tougher than I thought if one can survive against you. It's not much fun picking on the weak. I let him off easy this time, that's all. Don't get the wrong idea. Humans can only live for about 100 years? What a brief existence. It's not the length of your life. It's the density of it. I was going to read a destiny, but I realized. Yeah, but you're dancing a different way. But yeah, I wish we could live like, you know, a thousands of years. It would be pretty fun. You're probably the only overlord ever to have humans and angels as vassals. Oh, that's interesting. There were other humans that came to the Netherworld, but not like this. Huh? What do you mean by that? I guess he's referring to the queen, Lahar's mom. Okay? Recalling. Another fragment of my memory returned. It's a memory of when the king died. Publicly, it was reported that the king died by choking on a black pretzel. But that's not the truth. I believed that story too, until my memory returned. The king's death was... That's right, the king left to halt an invasion from an alternate netherworld. When he came back, he had lost almost all of his power. I was willing to save him in exchange for my life, the way the queen saved the prince. But the king wouldn't allow it, he told me to leave. Then, I can't remember the rest, but I made an important promise, something really important. So yeah, that's what really happened to King Krzyzewski. He actually fought the Lord of Nightmares. If you remember, that had been mentioned a couple of times by now. The Lord of Nightmares is a powerful overlord from another netherworld. Okay, let's buy a gun first. I don't have much money for weapons. Since everything is so expensive. Okay, this one. Yeah, sure, I can use this one on Gordon. Yeah, this is better. But as you can see, I'm wasting a lot of money. So I need to sell stuff. Wow, the Ion 9K Samurai. Oh, it's because I was like, why is this more costly? It's because this gun is custom. See, this is the Ion 8K Ninja. This is the Ion 9K Samurai. I see, that's interesting. I don't remember ever noticing that before. Okay, that's enough. I can, you know, finally buy better stuff. Okay, Jennifer is a monk, actually, I mean a brother. Yeah, this is the best weapon for Jennifer. Yep. Now I need to buy them armor, but you know what? Instead of buying what I have right now, I'm going to improve my... Where is it? Yeah, the shop. I want more expensive stuff. Let's see. Okay, I have pretty good support, so let's vote.
Yay, yay, nay, nay.
Yay, yay,
yay,
yay,
nay.
Yay,
yay,
yay.
Yay,
yay, yay,
yay,
yay,
yay,
yay,
yay,
yay.
More expensive stuff has been approved. So now I have access to better armor. It's more costly, but that's okay. Ooh, Mistral armor. It just gives me defense. Do I want this? Let's see what else can I get. Maybe there's something better or something with better, like, technicians or whatever you want to call them. Oh, here we go. This one gives me little speed, so I'm going to give it to Jennifer. Since, you know, martial artists need speed aside from attack. I'm gonna check that. Because on Disgaea too, fists were a speed weapon, so you need more speed to attack. I don't remember if Disgaea 1 had the same rules, so they just need attack, so we have to be careful with that. I'm going to give this to Thursday. And I almost spent all of my savings. And also I need a weapon for Thursday. Let's see what we can get. Ooh, Panda Claw. But I don't like the innocent that it has. I want, you know, a gladiator or something. Gladiators are great. They increase attack. No, I want the panda thing. Where's the panda? They just have Hypnotist. Hypnotist, I think it has a chance of putting the enemy to sleep. In this case, a 5% chance. Ooh, yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Oh, but I cannot buy it. Wait, I need to sell stuff. I can sell these ones. There we go. Now I can buy it. Oh yeah, you can rebuy your stuff in case you sold it by accident. Of course, they are going to, you know, be a little more expensive. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's a good attack. But I wanna buy more stuff, so... Yeah, I'm slowly running out of money, so I need to be careful with that. Also, this is interesting. This one has defense, because I guess of all the sentries, and this one doesn't, because it just has gladiators. I'm gonna give, like, one of those belts to Thursday, you know, he needs more attack. I'd rather give him this one. Also, we need more armor. I think Firefighter gives me defense against fire. So I can give it to Jennifer. Yeah, that's all the money I have. That's okay, don't worry, we can always get much more money later. Picnic at the Sea of Gehenna, Prince? You are still quite childish.
No, I'm not! I'm going to investigate the area!
picnic, picnic, la 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 la. So, you are going on a picnic. Okay, fervent melody, here we go. Oh yeah, this is Earth. I mean, it's pretty high tech.
It's past the scheduled time and still no word from Gordon. Apparently, even the Defender of Earth was no match for the Overlord.
He's not the real Defender of Earth. If you had just left it to me, I would have been done ages ago.
Oh yeah, this is Gordon's rival.
Are you still carrying on about that? You need to be more insightful, Curtis. It doesn't really matter to me whether he wins or loses. His mission ended as soon as he opened up a route to the Netherworld. Slaying the Overlord was just a pretext.
They're nothing but pawns to you, huh?
What an ugly way of saying it, Curtis. I prefer to call them the heroes who sacrificed their lives for the Earth.
Oh yeah, as you can see, this is the bad guy.
Gordon wouldn't die so easily. Only I, Curtis, can defeat him. I bet he beat the Overlord already and is enjoying a picnic right now, going la la la.
I mean, technically he's doing one of those things.
I never thought that picnicking in the Netherworld would be so delightful.
Is this guy really a hero? I'm not really one to say, but I always thought a hero was a bit more dignified. This guy's just a fool.
No, a true hero hides his real identity from the world, pretending to be quiet or weak. Then, when someone needs to be saved, he appears admirably to uphold justice.
I mean, you can describe Gordon as that, yeah.
That's right, isn't it?
Well, I guess.
La la la.
You sure? He looks like he doesn't have a care in the world.
La la la.
All right, they're falling for my plan.
Idiot.
Now, all I have to do is just play along until I can make a run for it.
Your continued existence hinges on an incredible unstable balance, do you understand? I am aware of that. Then, please take better care of yourself. I would like to, but I cannot leave them on their own. My power is not limitless. Please do not forget that. So yeah, it seems Seraph Lamington is, you know, keeping someone alive or something. Whoever he's been talking to. Ooh, no lifting and invincibility. Okay, I want to check something. Oh, Gordon has pretty good throw. Thursday cannot throw because, you know, he's a monster. I mean, if you look at Jennifer, she looks pretty cute, but then you look at Gordon and I think his head is a little too big for his body. I think what happened is that, you know, Gordon has his suit on, and as you can see, the suit is pretty baggy. So maybe when they were redrawing the sprite, they just saw the suit and assumed that was his body. That's why they made his head a little bigger. But in actuality, it should be a little, you know, smaller, like Jennifer. Jennifer's body looks almost proportionate to her. Or maybe I'm just, you know, overthinking stuff. Anyway, let's see, where is the geopanel? No lifting. And invincibility. Alright, now I remember what I have to do. I have to throw the enemies in here. And then block all the pathways. Yeah, now I remember. Yeah, so I can place Thursday in here. Neither Gordon nor Jennifer. I need to lure the enemies in here. So I'm gonna place a lure. In this case, Lahal. Yeah, he's gonna stay here and take some hits. So yeah, I cannot lift the these enemies, but at least I can train my other character. Let's see Gordon. He has Gordon Punch and Gordon Spark. Let's try Gordon Punch. Maybe he wanted to use Gordon Punch the other time and he couldn't because of Thursday. That's my theory at least, because it's the more powerful attack of the two. Jennifer has... ooh, Cosmic Arrow and Starbuster. She cannot use the Starbuster because, you know, Gordon is on the way. And what about Thursday? I can use Robo Attack. I mean, I don't mind. I don't think it's going to kill a heart or anything.
Gordon!
Okay, it did like damage him, but not that much. Maybe I can use... okay, I have an idea. Oh yeah, I cannot give people. Right, I forgot. They cannot kill me, but at least it's a good way to see, you know, how much damage the regular enemies are doing to your units. Without the risk, you know, of dying. Okay, that's good, Gordon. Okay, I'm gonna kill that one. Now I'm gonna... choose Jennifer. Oh yeah, but she doesn't have enough reach. I just Thursday.
Yeah. Terminate.
Oh, almost. I was really, really close. I guess I try to, yeah, I can use a chocolate. There we go. Thursday has a lot of defense, so it doesn't really matter. I can even, like, yeah, recover his SP. Oh, come on, wait. Why can't I use Robot Bazooka? Oh, it's because Thursday doesn't have that much SP, really? Oh, well, that was my bad. I need to work on that. Wait, I wanna try Jennifer's attack.
Yeah. Terminate!
Alright, not the best, but you know, it's something. I guess I can lure this one over here. Like, Gordon is just a magnet for enemies. There we go. Oh yeah, it's because I use an item, right? Yeah, let's put the heart in here and let's just move Golden over here. Wait, he has three burst. Maybe are you weak to water? Yeah! Perfect. There we go. Don't worry, I just wanted to showcase for now like Gordon and his team abilities. I'll train them off screen. They will be way better once the next episode comes around. I can assure you that much. Oh, he's paralyzed, but at least, you know, he has his attack, so... Now I can use Thursday, yeah, to attack. Oh yeah, he has 100%, like, you know, combo chance with Gordon and Jennifer. Dang it, I saw that legendary Ion 9K, I mean AK Ninja. Ooh. Man, really, I'm not like too excited for muscles now. Okay, I'm gonna pause the video, be right back. Okay, I'm back, and that's an interesting amount of HP, I should say. I guess I can give it to Thursday. Oh, by the way, I just realized that I need to, you know, organize my items a little better. Oh, there we go. I was looking for that. Yeah, I mean, just look how much HP he gains, like 999 HP. Yeah, it's even more than Laharl. Oh yeah, I wanted to check like Jennifer's attacks. Okay, they are based on attack only, so I should, you know, keep that in mind. I need to increase her attack, it's really low. What about Gordon? Okay, his attacks are based on, you know, attack stat too, so... Yeah. I wanna check Gordon's status. Okay, he can use axes, so we can go for that too, in case, you know... Actually, yeah, I think an axe will be better for Gordon. What about Jennifer? Okay, she's good with guns, but she prefers fists. Yeah, because in this case, Gordon's hit is not going to serve much for his attacks. Also, I just realized he doesn't have, like... anything good equipped except for the gun. Okay, I can give him the super belt. Well, let's try an axe. Yeah, the axe is much better. I'll check that off screen later. You're already a little behind schedule for this episode. Let's go to Wasteland of Woe.
Hey, what's wrong, Master? You're not having fun? I thought kids loved picnics. The sky is blue, the weather is perfect. Come on, let's sing.
I'm not a kid. I'm 1,313 years old. And mentally, I'm much more mature than you two.
Mature? I think you two are about the same. For your information, I'm 1,470.
Fairly young.
Young? How old is young?
Young is young.
You're an angel, aren't you? Tell the truth.
1,509.
What? You're older than me?
So yeah.
You old hag!
I'm not old.
That's amazing. No one would think you're that old.
That's why humans act so foolishly. They judge solely on looks.
Right, yeah, that is correct.
Ooh, you talk big. And you shouldn't mind my body, right?
I'm getting hungry. Let's eat.
Changing the subject, huh? I'll let it slide this time.
Here's the picnic.
On guard!
Ah, the picnic basket!
It has been a while, mademoiselle. The sweet smell of these entrees has led moi all the way here.
Hey, mid-boss! Give us back our food!
So yeah, this suddenly became a Kirby plot.
No. I cannot oblige. For moi, a widower, this handmade lunch is like an oasis in a desert.
A widower? Were you married?
I cannot give it back.
You return after all this time and for a stupid reason like this?
This is the first time I noticed that line about him being a widower.
Mr. Midboss, you don't have anyone to make lunch for you? Poor thing.
Stop pitying moi. That sends a sharp pain to my heart.
Hold it right there. Midboss, was it? That picnic basket is mine. Give it back now.
You are human, are you not?
That's right. They call me Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth.
And why is the Defender of Earth picnicking with demons?
Shut up! I'm not here because I want to be.
Very well. I shall test your resolve, O Defender of Earth. Now, can you retrieve this basket from moi?
Hey, you! Wait!
It's so pathetic that we put up with that idiot.
So yeah, Meat Boss is in here for now. Also, these enemies are really weak, aside from the dragons. Wait, they are weak, I just realized that. I can use the Dark Cannon to get rid of most of them, I think. Where are you, Jack? Here you are. Now I just need to... Yeah, it's always important to check the elevation. So I'm gonna place Jack in here. Dark Cannon right about here. So yeah, this was a little easier. And this way I can get rid of the cannon. Oops. All right, I won't be needing Jennifer. Just send Lahar and Flon over here, and finish. Okay, this dragon is weak to wind. How much HP does it have? Not that much. Oh wait, I can reach this tree. Maybe I can use fire instead. Oh yeah, much better. As for Lahar, I can use the Night Sever and maybe kill the dragon, maybe? Maybe I can use ice for those over there. None of these. I was trying to check if any of my attacks could, like, you know, hit all of them, but no. Very close. There we go. If I remember correctly, same as the mages, the dragons come in different elements, so they have different breath attacks based on the element they are assigned to. To be able to hit that. I can use fire on those two. Okay, perfect. Yeah, I'd rather have Lahar on this side. And I can just kill this dragon with whatever. Actually, that's a waste of my magic. I'm just going to use star. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about this one. I guess the Thursday can do the job. Then Jennifer. Yeah, it's 0% chance with combo with Gordon because he's asleep, so... Yeah. There is no way that he can combo if he's asleep. Okay, I'm gonna wake up Gordon and I'm gonna show you, like, you know, their combo. So yeah, it's 100%, it's pretty great. I almost had it. So I can now place Jennifer in here, Thursday, and Gordon. And this is great if you want to level them up because you can do all of three together. Oh yeah, she has better combo potential with Lahar. That's interesting. Yeah, I need to move faster. Okay, this one doesn't have a story. Recovery, 40%, attack 1, enemy boost, no lifting. Woof! It's going to be very annoying with this enemy, especially since he's level 40, so I need to destroy those. And apply this one, of course. The only one that worries me is the enemy boost. Yeah, this one. So I'm gonna send a mage to destroy this. With fire. Or maybe star. I'm going to send Flan. That's gonna make, you know, things much, much easier. There we go, and that makes the enemy, you know, a little less harder to deal with. Now let's destroy this one. And this one too, since we're already here. Oh yeah, she has now the Omega spells too. So I need to teach that to Flan. Which I will do, you know, off screen. If I recall correctly, in this game the Omega spells were the highest tier. And then... on the subsequent games, there was like Terra spells and then Penta spells. But maybe this game had Terra too. I think they had Terra, yeah. Terra Star, Terra Wind, Terra Fire, Terra Ice. Okay, speaking of ice, this one is weak to ice, so you know the drill. And I'll be sending, you know, Lahar, so I need Gordon for this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes! Perfect. Yeah, so Night Server is not like the same as Hurricane Slash. So it has better height, I think. Yeah, these demons can't move that much, but they sure are very resistant to everything. Even to the one thing they are weak to. Wow. Well, that's a free kill for Freya, I guess. Ooh, great. So yeah, now I just need to send Sloan over there to finish the job. So yeah, another thing Gordon is good for is, you know, throwing, and he has a lot of movement, and he's way more resistant than a thief, so... Yeah, that's what makes him so useful. We are still on time. I just need to, you know, go a little faster. Huh, where did our lunch go? Let's go home, this is pointless. I agree. We can leave now, we woke up early just to make it. That's right, as the defender of Earth, I cannot let our food fall in the hands of evil. You are just hungry. What are you talking about? This is the challenge by... this is a challenge by evil. I cannot turn my back on this ordeal. Justice must prevail. How wonderful, you really are a hero. Gordon, let's have Thursday search for the basket using this olfactory tracking device. His nose. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Thursday, can you pinpoint the location where the picnic lunch smell originates? Beep, beep, bleep, beep. No problem, Jennifer. Beep, 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 bleep. Analyzing air components, small traces of scent confirmed. Beep, 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 beep. Factoring in wind vectors. Projected coordinates lie in the area up ahead. Thanks, Thursday. Hey guys, the culprit's up ahead. The robot can do stuff like that too? Pretty useful. Of course, Thursday is a multi-purpose super robot. And the creator of Thursday is none other than Jennifer. She was a child prodigy who invented Thursday at age 5 and earned a PhD in every subject at age 10. Without her help, we would have never understood the secrets of the pyramids or solved the case of Jack the Tripper. Tripper. So, what did you, Bradley? This is incredible, Miss Jennifer. It's nothing, really. I thought you were just a dumb blonde, well, I guess I was wrong. Huh? Who was the one saying not to judge people by their looks, Harley? Did I say that? Anyways, we have to get the basket back before the meat boss eats it all. You're right, let's go. So yeah, Jennifer is actually a pretty smart person. But a PhD at age 10, I mean, a PhD on every field possible at age 10, I mean... That's a lot of reading, you know? Ah, okay, yeah, you can train in here, but nah... I guess I'll just, you know, use Obelor's Rat. Like this. And if they do survive, I can just flaunt. I almost hit myself. That was real scary. I guess I can use ice and then a star on the one in the middle. I guess I could just fire too. I'm surprised they survived. But don't worry, that's why I have like Flan and everyone else. Yeah! I can kill these two with... Yeah, I guess I can do it like this. And at least I get a little more experience for Jack. I am saddened by the fact that the new Disgaea 6, has like doesn't have sprites anymore. It just is just 3D model. Which, you know, the sprites just look really good. Those Disgaea 6 models are not going to age well when compared to these sprites. I mean, yeah, the PS2 sprites didn't age well either. But if you use a better monitor, they seem very crisp. And with your imagination, you can just fill in the blanks. So yeah. It makes me sad, but you know, those are how things are. I guess using 3D models was easier than just making a lot of sprites. I'm just gonna leave it there. Yeah, you can stop the animations if you press... I don't remember which one, but I just pressed them all. Oh, these two are weak to fire, that's great. Wait, I wanna try something. Yeah, now I have the fire attacks, and as you can see, I already have the first two tiers unlocked. Despite the fact that I haven't learned them, that's because of my staff mastery. There we go. Okay, I think Inferno is where mid boss is. So let's go. Inferno. Yeah, here we go.
My, my, what a gluttonous bunch you are, following Moa all this way.
Look who's talking.
Give it up! I swear by the name Defender of Earth that I'll get that basket back!
I just love how he says Defender of Earth.
are going to get hurt if you think that I am.
Oh, just give me a second. Sorry, I thought like a boss was passing by, so I decided just not to pause the video. Anyways.
Very well, I shall demonstrate for you humans the elegant techniques of the Dark Adonis.
Whoa, so bright. Shoot, at this rate, we'll lose.
Gordon.
Jennifer, Thursday, let's give it a go.
To protect the Earth from evil.
There is no rest for the champions of justice.
Captain Gordon, defender of Earth, here to save the day.
This isn't good. Maharl, Etna, there's something in the show.
Well, I don't really care. Yeah.
You should. We're joining in.
What? You serious, Flan?
I'm no longer ordinary, Flan. I'm Guardian Flan! All right, here we go! As long as evil exists in the world, this elegant angel will soar the skies! People's cheers bring me courage! Warrior of love, Guardian Flan!
Why do I have to be part of this?
I've never been so embarrassed in all my life!
But you see, this is a sign that they actually care for Flan. If they didn't, they wouldn't just be doing that, even if they, because they are so embarrassed about it.
Your teamwork is terrible compared to the defenders of Earth.
Jeez. We're being laughed at because of you two.
She's pissed, Prince.
I give up. Do what you want.
So yeah, let's go. Oh wow. I mean, at first it looks, you know, small, but then it opens up. I think the only thing I want to steal is the Falcon shoes. Aside from that, yeah, everyone else doesn't have like very good equipment. So, you know the drill, let's just play Lahar here as bait. Okay, the button you have to press to cancel the attack animations is X. Okay, they did take a lot of out of me, but I'm still here. I could use Wing Slayer on this tree. What about you, tree? You have a weakness to ice and you have a weakness to wind. So I guess I will be doing you separately. Oh, I can place Edna like in here. Or just use Flan and her, you know, magic attack. I just need to boost her a little. Magic boost. Magic boost and then Divine Ray. So magic boost.
Ultimate attack! Lord, give me strength!
Ooh, almost killed the dragon, even. Yeah, it was better than Lahar's, but only because her intelligence was boosted. Just look at that. That's a lot of intelligence. That was a big brain moment. Okay, let's try to steal from Meatballs. I think I can steal from two pistons. With the Bandit-chan, yeah! Ooh, excellent! There we go! That's all I needed. Yeah, I think I can kill it with... Yes! As for you two... Oh, you're both weak to wind. That's great. Ooh, this is perfect. Okay, you know, Meatboss is going to probably kill these two, or maybe it's going over here and kill all of them. But that doesn't matter, let's go. Oh wow, he's not even using like one of his super attacks or anything. So let's steal from him again. Yeah, this is a good speed for shoes. I mean, I guess I could steal the spike shield to reduce his attack, but I'd rather steal his HP first. As for you, you are very annoying. Wait, I don't want to hit myself with my own divine ray. I can use the Star Mage. I survive. Well, that gives me an idea. I'm just gonna hit Meatballs with a turret. So yeah, hopefully he will attack the turret instead of attacking me. As for you two, I guess I can... Oh, wait, I don't have any more units to throw at the enemies. But I want to use Gordon and company. I mean, Gordon has a gun. Yeah.
Here I come.
There we go. And let's let the last one just get closer. Ah, there we go.
Ha! Touché!
Ouch. Yeah, that was really painful. This should kill him. Oh wow. Alright, since you don't want to die. There we go.
You lose again. Now give back the picnic basket.
Oh.
Unfortunately for you, I have already consumed the contents!
You fiend! How dare you!
That means this duel is a draw! We shall meet again! My compliments to the chef!
That bastard!
Our lunch!
Oh, it's okay. We can always make it again.
Jennifer's right. Lunches are expendable.
I just love like the emphasis he puts on that.
Which reminds me, I haven't had Pizza Shack's teriyaki pizza in a long time. Now then, since this is all over, we'll be heading back to Earth. There's no need to shed any tears. So long, people of the Netherworld.
I just love how casual he is about trying to escape.
You go, Gordon. Take it nice. No one, not even a demon, can deny a man his Pizza Shack teriyaki pizza. Now, if I can just return to Earth and act like nothing ever happened.
You know, I could care less about you leaving, but how do you plan on getting out of here?
Huh? No! Now that you mention it, our spaceship is in pieces.
Aw, that's pretty sad.
We have no way of getting home.
Indeed.
Gordon, you just realized that?
Jeez Louise.
Oh, my perfect plan.
Too bad, Gordon. Your fate is to be my vassal.
Will we ever be able to return to Earth? Who will defend the planet now? Will my duty as defender of Earth go unfulfilled?
Oh yes, I have an idea, Mr. Gordon. Why don't you change from defender of Earth to defender of the Netherworld?
What? I could never do that.
Oh, come on, Gordon. The Earth isn't the only world. Our duty is to safeguard peace, whether it be on Earth or in the Netherworld.
I mean, yeah, that's right.
But that title doesn't sound right.
That is also true. Defender of the Netherworld doesn't sound as good as Defender of Earth.
Fine, I'll give you a good title. In the name of King Laharl, I knight thee Slayer of the Netherworld.
That is actually a pretty cool title.
Hey, wait. That's not any better.
I promoted you from being a vassal. Quit complaining.
Yeah, that is right.
Does that mean we can stay here, Harley?
Your unusual abilities. They'll come in handy as I take control of the Netherworld. Oh, I'll try to tolerate that sexy body of yours.
He's growing up.
I never thought I'd hear the word tolerate come from his mouth.
Yeah.
Well, that's as close to acceptance as he gets, right? Of course, it could just be that he started liking sexy bodies.
Beep, beep, bleep, beep. All's well that ends well.
It's not well. This is a dream. It must be a dream. Somebody tell me it's a dream!
And that's how these people were welcomed into King Laharl's court. I know I helped the demons get the humans on their side. But these days, I'm not so concerned about that kind of stuff.
Yeah, how interesting.
I hope one day all angels, demons, and humans can live happily together just as we do. The end.
Episode 10, Angels, Demons, and Humans.
With the EDF Armada steadily advancing, it's up to Air Defense me Force. To protect the Netherworld!
What can a little girl do?
Mega Curse Cannon! Anything in the air is toast!
Not bad.
Plasma Magic Circle! Nothing can get past this baby!
Ugh, impossible.
And the ultimate weapon, the Freak Flan! With her idealistic notion of peace and love, she'll annoy you into submission!
Ugh, how dreadful!
Next on Legend of the Netherworld Heroine, Episode 11, Etna versus EDF. Another page in the Netherworld's history.
We can't just sit here. All forces, move out!
So yeah, at this point we are pretty close to the end of the game. I think this game only has like 13 or 14 chapters. So yeah, it's been a good run so far. But anyways, enjoy the video, leave a like, have something to say, comment down below. One more, please subscribe. Is this video ending? You can bet it is. So thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.